Welcome to Saurav Sir Classes. Today's tutorial will be on food stamps. In case of any query, you can contact us on this particular number. And we are also available online and you can contact us on www.saurav sir classes.com. Here we will actually see the scenario that generally operates in India. Okay. In India, what happened is that targeted households as a part of say poverty alleviation scheme, okay, poverty alleviation scheme, are provided with some food coupons, say of rupees. So there is a food coupon, or say there is a cash subsidy of rupees 2000. So this means a family now receive a cash subsidy of rupees 2000 a year to get these food coupons. So you can get, using this cash subsidies, you can get these food coupon. So we are framing the question in such a way that you are receiving a cash subsidy of rupees 2000 and you can use it to buy the food coupons. And this is generally, we see that is done in India as a poverty, say a poverty alleviation scheme. Okay. Now, what will happen to the budget line? So first, let us draw the initial budget line. So let us consider the two axes. Now, this cash subsidy, you will get some food coupon and this can only be used to buy food. And this subsidy you can only use to buy food and you cannot use it for any other purpose. Cannot be used for any other purpose. Okay. So on the two axes, what I'll measure is that on the horizontal axis, I'll be measuring food, and on the vertical axis, I'll measure all other commodities. And this can include money even, okay? So, say this is our initial budget line. Okay? It will be downward sloping because if you want to have something more, you have to give up the other commodity. Okay, so it will be downward sloping following this logic. Now, we have received rupees 2000 as a cash subsidy, which we will utilize to buy the food coupons. So, how the budget line will change? We will have something like this. Now, let me tell you first, what does this mean? This actually means that the maximum number of food that the consumer can consume, so maximum amount of food that say consumer is that A can consume has increased by 2000 everywhere, because 2000 is the amount of cash subsidy which has to be utilized only on food. So we will have a budget line like this. Okay, and this point on the horizontal axis accounts food is equal to 2000. So we get a kink here. So we have a kinked demand curve, kinked budget line, kinked budget line. Okay. So what happens is that we see that this intercept, this was the earlier intercept of food, and this there has been an increase, but the intercept of all other good axes remains unchanged. Question is why? This is because A cannot use the cash subsidy to on other goods? Because he cannot use the cash subsidy on other goods, he can still have, say, if this was, say, arbitrarily, it was 5,000 units of this particular good he was having. So he still have 5,000 units of this good only. Okay, this 2,000 will not be added here, because it has to be exclusively spent on only food. So that's why we get a king demand function, king budget line. Now, if there wouldn't have been such kind of restriction, then our new budget line would have been something like this. So if this is food and this is others, okay, and we have an initial budget line like this, and if we get a cash subsidy on which there is no restriction, if this time there is no restriction and you can use it on any good, then there would have been a parallel shift of the budget line, saying that the consumption or the intercept of both the goods, the intercept on both the sides would have changed, okay? And now you can spend this cash subsidy on any good, okay? So that's why there would have been a parallel shift. But we are actually obtaining, or we actually get a kinked budget line just because of this restriction that it cannot be used for any other purpose. I hope this tutorial on food coupons or food stamp was helpful to you guys. If yes, then please like and leave a comment, and stay tuned for our upcoming interesting videos. Thank you for watching.